Good morning, everyone. I hope your day is going great. Your Tuesday is starting off great and wonderful for you and peaceful. I woke up this morning and I received a phone call. And like I said, I've been speaking to people, getting advice, and you know, especially in the government, government officials. You know, I've been trying to speak to them. Believe me, gentleman, he called me, and I understand that they election is coming up and stuff, you know, and it's more like, what do I do in this situation? So you have people working behind the scenes. Just because you don't see a lot of people showing their faces, that doesn't mean that they're not concerned. And he checked out some things, you know. I told him to go on YouTube. I said, you most likely will see it on YouTube. You might see a little bit, you know, on the other social media. And he sent me a link to, you know, read on rallies and being organized and when to do a rally, when it's best to do a rally, and how effective the rallies are. You have to be effective with your rallies by doing it at a certain time and being organized. And that's what, you know, if once we get organized, like I said in one of my videos, you know, let's get back on track. Let's get organized. Let's do this the right way. Because if we're not effective, you know, and we don't have progress and we're not working, everybody have values in this, you know. We might have some, we have so many robber supporters and they in different states. We might have someone that know the airline company and they probably can give you a discount, you know, hashtag free R. Kelly or hashtag R. Kelly supporter. You know, you might know somebody or know a big hotel chain and they can reach out and get discounts and stuff, you know, hashtag R. Kelly supporter, you know, get discounts. You know, you might have someone that know someone in Chicago that's in the government official that we can speak to. You know, getting somebody to go in and speak to whoever we fight against. But, you know, we, like I said, we is things you have to do in the right way, in a professional way, and not be ugly about it. You know, and I have to look at myself sometimes and I'm like, you know, I always tell my kids, you know, I don't do this and don't do that. Sometimes I have to look back at myself, you know, and I'm like, I have kids, adult kids, and I want to be a example for my kids and my grandkids. You know, I can't be sitting up there, you know, going off and stuff because if somebody's wrong, you know, it's the right way to deliver things. But I feel like once we get ourselves organized and we get a plan together and we dominate that plan and, you know, and stop adding fuel to the fire, this will be something great, effective. Like I said, we don't have time to waste right now. It's like the clock is ticking, really. The clock is ticking. And this is the outcome of what we're fighting for is going to start in Chicago for his trial, his first trial, you know. So we have to get it right. We have to get it right. We can't, you know. We need leaders. We need speakers. I mean, he was talking to me about a lot of stuff, you know. The best time to do it, you know, lunch break is when a whole lot of people coming out. And he's saying when you make yourself known and let people see what you're doing, he said that it'll be noticed. And so, you know, setting time, dates, and locations and stuff, you know. Whoever we're trying to target, if it's Kim Fox, you know. Her, I mean, whatever, you know, or in front of, you know, the courthouse, you know, we just have to have a plan. We have to have it set up right. You know, we have to have, you know, it's great to have speakers. You want to have speakers. It'll be great to have somebody or some people to speak on how Robert helped them in their life, you know, how he donated, you know, how he stepped in to help, buried, you know, kids, you know, just great things about this guy. And it's not going to hurt anyone to just be the bigger person in things and ignore the foolery, because we have to do this right. I mean, we have skills. Everybody have a talent. God gave everybody a talent. May it be somebody that'll go be, you know, in the spot for the rally. You know, they're early for people that's coming. There are people that want to, you know, pitch in and buy water and get ice and coolers and, you know, put it in there and snacks and stuff. You know, everybody can be a part of this fight for the cause. We all can give something. If it's not money, we can give our talent, we can give our time. But we all can be a part of this, and it can go right. And I said, Lord, I want you to place me in the right spot in this, because I'm not going nowhere, you guys. And like I said, you know, and I'm a very passionate person. I'm like, God, don't let me cry when I talk. So I'm going to try not to do that. It's a reason that I'm fighting for Robert right now. And as I said, as a little girl and a teenager, he gave me great respect when I didn't get respect from men that I was taken advantage of as a little girl. And this man gave me great respect, and I respect him for that. And I'm going to always fight for him. And I'm not going anywhere. So, I mean, I'm going to be a part of it. If I have to be a part by myself, if I have to be a part of the plan and thing. But I'm going to be in this fight. I'm going to be a part of this fight. I'm going to be a part of his fight. We're going to be okay. Let's get that rally. He told me a rally. And letting people see that and showing, it's effective, just like social media. So, yeah, you know, Miss Spitting Fire, you know, she was, you know, spoke on the rally. And, you know, that's why I said God is who he is, because this man called me about the rally. And then I got a notification of Spitting Fire, so I clicked on to see. And she was speaking. I'm like, okay, she mentioned rally. So, you know, maybe this is something God is showing. But change is going to come. But we have to be positive, and we have to be effective, and we have to have plans and goals and stuff. You know, so I'm gonna leave you guys on that. But we're gonna do good. We're going to be all right. Cause I'm in this, you guys. I'm not bagging out. Not me. Like I said, I have thick skin. I'm not, because we all know you're not fighting for nothing. The majority of the people that's fighting see what I see, and the majority of the people see it. Reach out to your public officials and stuff, and civil rights activists. A lot of them might do it behind the scenes, because it's like a straddling the fence type thing with them. They, you know, a lot of people want to win, and they feel if I go on this side, I'm going to lose these people. If I go on this side, I'm going to leave. So let them work behind the scenes. There's a lot of people working behind the scenes, just like I said with the attorney. Just because they're not telling us everything, that doesn't mean nothing. The people are not going to put that out there. So let's not worry about the next person. Let's just see what kind of a change, and how can we be effective in this fight. Because I'm not going nowhere. What roles need to be filled? You know what I'm saying? So we all have a part. In this, and we all can play a part, be positive, you know, just like somebody might know some some people might know security, or you know, somebody that we, you know, can come in so we can have a peaceful rally, be protected at the same time. And like I said, everybody can play a part in this. Everybody can be effective in this. So, you know, let's get it together, because I'ma sit in whatever part I need to play in, I'm going to play in it. So, just let R. Kelly sing a little bit to y'all. All right, Robert. I'm trying to tell us it's going to be a change, you guys. And I feel like he is the one. You know, sometimes it's like a sacrifice. And he might be that sacrifice for that change for us to try to get things together. You know, so we can do this, you guys. I feel it like strong in my heart. I just want everybody to be safe, and listen, I'll not get into our feelings. You know, we don't want to make this something dangerous. We're fighting for freedom. We're fighting for our brothers, and we're fighting for our sisters. And it's not a black and white thing, you know. Do you know, Robert, when I said the fans are real, and he has fans in Korea, China, Africa, Caucasians. The fans are real. So, you know, Robert has, you know, different fans, like different colors. You know, it's not a race thing. It's the right thing. It's about the right. And we know that this is wrong. And we just need to pull together. We don't have to know each other or be buddies and all that, but you know, pulling together to try to make this great, you know, just pulling together and make it great. So just marinate on that. I don't have no speech or nothing in this, but I'm just, you know, I just want to just throw this in y'all. So I'm just end this with Robert. Another song with him.
I remember when me and my brothers, we used to sit up on the porch in the summertime and just talk about just making it, you know what I'm saying? Being successful, following after our dreams, you know? And I believe that's every kid's dream, you know what I'm saying? To rise and be somebody, but damn, sometimes we just get caught up.
I ain't got no money. Like my world is coming to an end. No food on the table.
Searching for that paradise.
Oh Lord, will you help me find me? Take this crazy, crazy past of mine and put it all behind me. Look down on the ghetto man and change his mission and put it in the hearts of many to stop confusion.
As I look into my life, searching
we need to moan for love. My sisters, brothers, let's put these hands together.
As I look,
we
into
need to stop choking on the truth and stop smoking on the plan. Man, love and respect that woman and bring her happiness.
As I look,
I'm talking to the ghetto,
searching for
each other we should help. While our babies are dying in the street, we've got to be saying to ourselves,
as I look into my life, searching for that paradise. As I look into my life, searching for that paradise.
Help me find me. Take this crazy, crazy past of mine and put it all behind me. Look down on the ghetto man and change his mission and put it in the hearts of many to stop confusion.
As I look into my life,
Let's put these hands together.
As I look,
we need to stop choking on the truth.
And
stop smoking on a plan. Men love and respect that woman. And bring her happiness.
As I look,
I'm talking to the ghetto.
Searching for
each other, we should help. While our babies are dying in the street, we've got to be saying to ourselves.
As I look into my life, searching for that.
Everyone have a blessed week, and remember, let's stick together. We all have something to offer this cause. Let's use our God-given talents, and let's be positive, be safe, and let's win this fight.